The one I want to talk about in this video is a really interesting and unique harmonica made by the Seydel company. It's actually in the form of the Seydel Session Steel. It's got this nice, cool orange comb, full-length covers, and you can probably see there's a little plunger sticking out the end. Well, that is Jim Antaki's TurboSlide. Now, the TurboSlide uses magnets to affect the pitch of the blow reeds, and of course magnets only work with steel reeds. And Seydel is the only manufacturer to make harmonicas with steel reeds, so there's a natural, you know, combination of the two. Now this particular one is quite an unusual one because it's tuned in Powerbender tuning, which is a tuning I came up with a couple of years ago, and also it's half-valved. And again, Seydel is the only major manufacturer that allows players to choose their own tuning. They go into the Seydel website with their configurator, and you can choose your own tuning, or you can choose from a list of common tunings. And the power bender is listed there. And you can also choose it to have it half valved or unvalved or whatever. So this is a key of a session steel and the key of a half valved with the turbo slide. So that's what I want to talk to you about in this video. Now, if you like the power bender tuning and you just want to play away, you can just forget about the turbo slide altogether, and it sounds really good. Okay, so I'm not using the turbo slide at all there, but the harp plays perfectly normally. The magnets sit out of the way and the harp just responds as normal. But if you want to bring the turbo slide into action, it gives you some very cool extra effects. For instance, it gives you the missing notes. Whatever tuning you're using, there is on a diatonic harmonica, there's always going to be some missing notes you have to get by overblowing or maybe valve bending. But in this case, the turbo slide gives you those missing notes really easily. There's no special mouth technique. You just push the slider in and there they are. For instance, the note missing between one draw and two blow, that's a common one that's missing on the Richter tuning and the power bender. So you've got one draw and two blows. There's a semitone missing there. Normally you have to overblow the one draw, which is not easy to get that note. But on the with the turbo slide, you just push play the two blow and push the slider in, and there it is. You notice I'm operating the turbo slide with my thumb. So that's a really good thing about it. You can keep your hands in cup position, but operate the turbo slide with your thumb. So there's that missing note. Okay, so easy. And the same thing applies for all the other missing notes that you can't get on a normal harp. On a Richter harp, the note between four draw and five blow, or the note between five draw and six blow, which you normally have to overblow, you can get with the turbo slide. On this power bender harp, there's missing notes between six draw and seven blow. Okay, there's a missing note there. Now, likewise between eight draw and nine blow. Okay, now I can get it with the turbo slide. So you can get fully chromatic scales really easily just with the turbo slide and draw bending technique. Okay, so it turns the harp into a fully chromatic instrument with no fancy embouchures that you have to master, no fancy setup, just pushing the old turbo slide. It also gives you some cool sort of whammy sort of effects. For instance, you can use it for little trills, that kind of thing. But the thing that I really like about the turbo slide, which wasn't I think in Jim's intentions when he designed it, was to that it allows you to get some extra big draw bends. And these are really interesting because basically on any harp you can bend the draw note or the high note in each hole nearly down to the pitch of the low note, but you can't bend it any lower. It's interactive reed bending, that lovely sound that we all know and love. There's number two draw. Now you can bend that a full tone down because your blow note is a tone and a half down. So here's the bend. But you can't get that any lower. Now that's a great bend, the flat seventh. But if I push the turbo slide in, then my blow note goes down the semitone. But the draw note stays the same. And the draw note and the turbo slide affected blow note are still in the same vocal tract. Therefore, I can bend that to draw down an extra semitone because the blow note has gone down an extra semitone. So have a listen. That's normal. Push the turbo slide in. Hear that? I can bend it an extra semitone down. Now that note there is the same note as to blow. So now I can get that and put vibrato on it. Okay, and the same thing applies all the way through the rest of the harp. Wherever you've got a draw note and a blow note below it, on a Richter harp you can bend five draw down a semitone, which is not normally possible. On the power bender, you can get some very cool things. For instance, in hole number seven draw, you can normally only bend that a semitone. A nice note, but if you wanted to bend it a full tone, you can go push the turbo slide in. Okay, gives you a nice extra bend. Okay, for instance, on number nine draw, you can bend that now down a tone and a half instead of just a tone. Here's the normal one. It's the same as two draw. But now you can push the turbo slide in and I can bend that down an extra semitone. Okay, so these are some extra beautiful effects from the turbo slide, in addition to the whammy bar sort of sounds, which you can only get on the harmonicas which have got these steel reeds. So if you're going to go to the Seydel website and you're buying a Seydel harmonica with steel reeds, I recommend getting the Session Steel, Richter tuning, power bender tuning, whatever tuning you like, valved or half valved, and going that extra step and getting the Jim Antaki's cool turbo slide fitted, because it doesn't affect the normal playability of the harp, but it does give you a whole lot of extra very cool effects that you can get that you can't get in any other way.